Hello everyone, welcome back to our channel Murga English Academy. Myself Kukishmita, and today on 23rd of July I am going to start mathematics for class 6. So today we will start a new chapter, which is whole numbers. Okay, lesson 3. So whole numbers starts from 0. Okay, we know that the numbers 1, 2, 3, 4, etc. are used for counting. As they come naturally when we start counting, they are called natural numbers. Generally, on adding 1 to any natural number, we get the next natural number. That is successor. The successor of 25 is 26. As the number 25 comes just before 26, we say that the predecessor of 26. Okay, so the successor of 25 is 26 and the predecessor of 25 is 24. Okay, predecessor means the previous number, and successor means the number we have to add 1. Okay, to get successor we have to add 1. Now see, whole numbers, as 1 has no predecessor. Okay, 1 has no predecessor. 2 had predecessor. It is the predecessor of 2 is 1, but 1 has no predecessor. In natural numbers we add 0 as the predecessor for 1. Okay, 0 is called the predecessor of 1, but 0 is not a natural number. To the collection of natural numbers, the natural numbers along with 0 form the collection of whole numbers. That means all the natural numbers are whole numbers along with 0. 0 is not a natural number, but 0 is a whole number. Okay, so for whole numbers there are some properties for addition, subtraction, multiplication and division. So let's see properties of addition. There are four properties: closure property, commutative property, associative property and zero property. Okay, so closure property is a whole number when added to another whole number gives a whole number as the answer. This means that the sum of any two whole number is always a whole number. It is closure property. Okay, for example, see here 8 plus 9 is 17. So 8 is a whole number, 9 is a whole number, then and the answer we got 17. 17 is also a whole number. Okay, so when we add two whole numbers, then the answer we get, it is also a whole number. So it is closure property. Then commutative property: the sum of the whole numbers is always the same irrespective of the order of number. This property is known as commutative property. Okay, whatever the order is when we add two whole numbers, whatever the order of the number, the answer is same. Okay, so let a b are two whole numbers. So a plus b is equal c. Okay, when we add two whole numbers, that means a plus b is equal c. If we change the order, that means if we write b plus a, then also we get c. Okay, so for example, c 1 plus 2. Okay, 1 and 2 is whole number, so the answer we get 3. Then if we change the order, that means if we write 2 plus 1, then also we will get 3. Okay, so it is commutative property. Then see associative property: the sum of the numbers always remain the same irrespective of the way they are grouped. This property is known as the associative property of addition. Okay, so it is associative property. Sum of the numbers always remains the same. Okay, sum of numbers, if you add more than two or three numbers, see the example 1, use different grouping to add the following: 4 plus 6 plus 8, different grouping. See, 4 plus 6 plus 8 is 18. So first see the grouping arrangement. 4 plus 6, they are giving bracket in 4 plus 6. That means they are first adding 4 and 6. Then with that answer, they are adding 8. That means 10 plus 8, 18. Then in next, 4 plus 6 plus 8, they are giving bracket in 6 and 8. So first they are doing addition of 6 plus 8. So 6 plus 8 is 14. That means again 14 plus 4 is 18. That means same answer. Okay, whatever the group is, we will get the same answer. Okay, now see zero property. According to the zero property, the addition 0 added to any whole number gives the number itself. Okay, if you add 0 with any number, whatever the order is, you will get the same answer. Okay, then properties of subtraction, properties of multiplication and properties of division are there. Okay, you go through these properties from your book. Okay, so in next class we will discuss exercise 3.1. Thank you for today.